the sea is really shallow, so the ship cannot be taken out very quickly. That also making the damage really, really massive. To regrow coral that's been damaged massively, it needs like 10 to 20 years to grow. But this system, it could be regrow in 2 years.
Hello, I'm Hannah, and this is What in the World, your podcast for the stories that everyone's talking about from the BBC World Service. Today, we're bringing you a story from Raja Ampat, which is a group of islands in Indonesia. And it's sometimes called the underwater Amazon because it is an amazing sight for divers. And this story is about how a massive luxury cruise ship ran aground on a coral reef there back in 2017. And how, since then, local women and local communities have been working hard to restore the corals. Let's find out more about this now from Lesthia Kertopati, who's a BBC journalist in Jakarta. Hi, Lesthia.
Hello.
So take me back to 2017 when this cruise ship ran into the reef. It sounds like it was an absolute disaster. What exactly happened?
Yeah, it was happened in 4 March of 2017. So this British vessel called Caledonian Sky, it was a luxury cruise ship that take around 100 tourists from multinational countries, and it ran aground in the shallow waters of Kri Island. The sea is really shallow, so the ship cannot be, taken out very quickly. And that also making the damage of the coral really, really massive.
This area, Kri Island, Raja Ampat, is a protected area, isn't it? It's meant to be one of the most biodiverse marine ecosystems in the world, and it's really popular with divers. So when this ship ran aground on top of this coral reef, it must have been really, really devastating. What kind of damage did it cause?
All the coral turns white because of that.
Like coral bleaching?
Yes, like coral bleaching. So the local resident cannot fish there anymore because there's no fish living there. When coral dies, coral is like the home for environmental marine biodiversity. So in the coral, there will be fish and also seaweed and a lot of, small animals that become the feed for the fish. So when the coral dies, a lot of marine biodiversity will die as well, or they move out to another place that have the coral. So the environment surrounding the islands is now become empty with no marine lives.
I read that it was about 1,600 square meters worth of damage, which is roughly the size of, 3 football fields. What was the reaction like when this incident happened?
Yes, people really angry because, the people of Raja Ampat mostly depended on the sea for their livelihood, their fishing, and also they're really dependent on the tourism there. So when the incident happened and the environmental damage were so massive, they couldn't fish there anymore. There's no fish to be catch, and then there's no tourists coming. So, people lost their livelihood and they asked the government for compensation because of that. And there is also pressure for our government how to make this better. So because this is not only become the livelihood of the locals there, but also it become the pride of Indonesia. Our government, they want to make tourists come to Indonesia to see the beautiful of Indonesia, but people can get in and do anything they like without any rules and regulation to protect that.
And there was a big investigation into what went wrong too, right?
True, yes.
What were the findings?
And it's a very, really long investigation as well. They find both parties are responsible, the Indonesian government and as well as the owner of the ship, the Caledonian Sky. So the investigation find that the damage of the coral reef is so massive. And it's decided that the owner of the Caledonian Sky needs to take responsibility towards that. And also our government, the Indonesian government, needs to make sure that the restoration of the reef, it's be done in a very swift manner. Eventually, the government and also the owner of the ship decided to settle this incident outside of the court. It said it's millions of dollars of settlement. That money is going to be used for a restoration of the coral reefs and also to build the community of the locals there.
And how do you restore a coral reef once it's been damaged so much that it turns white, that all the fish desert it like that?
So the Indonesian government, under the Ministry of Environment, they collaborate with the University of Hasanuddin in Sulawesi to lead this project of rehabilitation. And they have this program that called Reef Stars. So they make a hexagonal structure from steel. When, you know, people put small fragmentation of corals and then it then tied to the seabed, so the new coral will grow there. Usually to regrow coral that been damaged massively, it needs like, you know, decades, years and years to make them grow back. But this system, the Reef Star system, and also the method that they call microfragmentation, it's said to make the corals grow faster. The one that usually needs like 10 to 20 years to grow, it could be regrow in 2 years.
One thing I found really beautiful about this story was the role of local indigenous communities, particularly women, in regrowing the corals.
Yes, so in Raja Ampat, women are really, really active in participating in every ways of life. So the Hasanuddin University, the one that led the project, take participation of more than 80% of women of Yenbuba indigenous community, one of the community that lives there, to participate in this project. And the women, they're really eager to, you know, to do all of this restoring project, from building the coral, the reef stars, until, you know, taking the fragmentations of the corals. And they even put the reef stars by themselves into the seabed. They also involve in giving the clue to the scientists of which coral in which location. So they're the one who show them, because they live there for a generation and they know better, the environment better rather than the scientists. The whole village involved in this.
So
mostly
you,
women.
You say it takes a village to bring
yes.
up children. It also
takes
a village to regrow coral. And how successful has this been? It's been, what, 8 years since the damage happened. When did they start the restoration and how's it going?
So the restoration itself take off around from January 2025 until now. So it's been few months.
Okay.
But they already seen some grow. So they already planted more than 2,000 reef stars. They already see the one that grow back. People start to fish there again. Like the whole team that doing this restoration project really hope that what they do could benefit for the future generation, because one of the villagers there that we interviewed said that the coral reefs that they have in their island is borrowed from their children's and grandchildren's for the future. So they need to take care of it.
And I was wondering if the laws changed, because this is a protected area. It was a national park. Did the Indonesian government change the laws regarding whether big ships, big vessels could actually come into this area?
There is new regulation regarding that. But Indonesia is now also focusing on mining in small islands such as Raja Ampat. And this is being criticized by the environmental activists. And if this mining in the future happen, then maybe the damage could be worse than this vessel that ran aground.
So people will be watching closely to see what happens in Raja Ampat.
Yes, that's true.
I went diving and snorkeling around the Gili Isles in Bali when I was 18, and the biodiversity there is some of the most amazing water, some of the most incredible fish and turtles that I've ever seen in my life. So I really do hope that they all go back to Raja Ampat and can call it their home again.
Yes, imagine if you said Bali and Lombok is beautiful, Raja Ampat is much more beautiful than that.
Well, maybe one day in the future when it is fully restored and all of the coral has regrown and the fish are back, then maybe I can visit.
You have to.
Lesthia, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And that's it from me. But if you like this, do check out our other episodes. Please like, follow, share, subscribe. You can find us right here on the BBC World Service YouTube channel 5 days a week, and twice a week we are chatting away in the studio. So I hope to see you back here. I'm Hannah. This is What in the World from the BBC World Service. See you next time.